In this video, we're going to take a look at the state method and understand how you can take advantage of some of the built-in DBT artifacts and functionality to help with creating a type of selective CI for your project. So really what's going to happen here is we're going to compare two manifests, and a manifest is an overall document, an artifact that explains everything about your project. So what we want to do is get a baseline manifest, which would be from master branch typically, save that somewhere, and we'll point that using either the state flag or setting an environment variable. Then once we make a change, we'll recompile our changed version of our project and compare it. That might sound a bit confusing, but we'll walk through it and hopefully it'll make some more sense. So first thing, we'll just do a DBT compile. And what we know about compile is that it'll go through and make that initial manifest artifact, and it will store it for us here in our target folder. So here we have manifest.json. Here's that big manifest file with everything about our current project. This ultimately is what we're going to want to compare as a state flag. This is what we want to use as the comparison. But we can't leave it here, because if we do, the next time we run, it's just going to override this file here. So what we can do is actually move this. And you can do something like this, move, and we'll do target-manifest.json. And I'm just gonna say dot, so that it moves it to the root of this project. It's no longer in here. That manifest.json is right here. Now, once we recompile or rerun or do anything, it's going to create a new version of that manifest, but this will remain here for us to compare. Just to prove that, I'll go DBT compile, and we'll see it again show up here. So here it is again. Here's that one we moved. Right now, they are the same. And just to prove that currently there are no differences, we'll run this command down here, dbtls models, and now we're using this state modified. So what this is in place of is, instead of listing each of the models individually, by using this state modified method, it's going to compare these two states, these two manifests together. But remember, we have to provide that comparison, so we'll have to add this as well, and we'll just say dot, because it'll know to just look here. Let's go ahead and run that. No nodes selected. And that's because they're the same. Now let's make a change and test that this now returns the name of the changed model. So let's go in here now. We'll go to teams, and let's just add another union for the sake of it. I don't know, what's a good team here? We'll do Bulls, Chicago Bulls. So now this node, once we recompile, this node would be different in the new compiled manifest compared to what we have out here, which again is that original version. So we'll do this same thing, list the models that are modified, and we're comparing the whatever the new version of the manifest is to this original one. We're saying dot because it's at the root of the directory. That's where this file, this comparison manifest exists. If we put it somewhere else, we'd have to change that. And there it is. We see example.teams. So it was able to recognize it and put that through to us. Now, if we were to run, it would run just that one model. And here we can see it's running that one table. And if we hop into Snowflake, we should be able to see that. We should see the bulls in here now, and there it is. So now you can see that's how this modified method is going to work. Another thing I'll mention here is that although we used the state modified, there is another option to do state new, which would only look at brand new nodes added to your manifest. Modified will cover both new and modified, but that other option is available. Also, there are some known caveats to this method that DBT does explain in another section of their documentation, and I encourage you to read through that, specifically around tests and just some potential gaps that you just need to be mindful of. But that'll do it for this particular video. Hopefully now you have a baseline understanding of how this works and can start to incorporate it in your project and maybe simplify your CI process.